In this video, I want to provide a description of the syllabus which we're going to cover in the undergraduate course. So, at the back of our minds within the undergraduate course, and actually at the graduate level as well, the idea is that there is some population. And within that population, there might be countries, there might be individuals, there might be firms. And the idea is that we don't actually have the whole population data set. We only have a sample from that population. So perhaps we have just these sort of figures which I'm sort of highlighting here in purple. And these individuals form a sample data set. And the idea with econometrics is that we want to use some sort of tool, some sort of statistical or mathematical tool on that sample to enable us to make some sort of inference about what's going on in the population, or to make some sort of estimation of some sort of population parameter. So what exactly do I mean by sort of estimating a population parameter? So there might be a relationship between the level of wage which an individual sort of obtains and their level of education, which is given by this sort of relationship here, which I've sort of drawn mathematically. And the idea here is that the sort of coefficient beta might represent the sort of effect of 1 year extra of education on a sort of individual's average level of wages. And that would be sort of defined within our population. That would be the sort of average effect of 1 year of education on wages within the population. But the idea is that we don't actually have the whole population's data, we only have a sample from that data. So we'd like to use our tool on the sample to enable us to estimate this particular parameter, in this case, beta. When we first start off talking about estimation techniques, we're going to first start off discussing cross-sectional data. So that might be when we have the level of wages and the level of education for a set of individuals at one point in time. And it just so happens that under a certain set of criteria, that a tool which we call ordinary least squares happens to be quite a good tool to use on our sample. So under a certain set of criteria, ordinary least squares happens to be what we call blue. So that means it's the best linear unbiased estimator possible. Don't worry if you don't understand what that means, we're going to cover that in due course. The set of criteria which need to be fulfilled are what we call the Gauss-Markov assumptions. And assuming that each of these is satisfied, then ordinary least squares are a sort of useful thing to use on our sample. But how do we actually go ahead and test these certain criteria? Well, we need a sort of set of what we call diagnostic tests. And what these tests enable us to do is they enable us to test as to whether it's the case that these criteria are satisfied. And if each of these criteria are satisfied, that's fine, we can still use OLS on our sample, and that will enable us to make some sort of good estimate about the population parameters. But if these criteria aren't satisfied, so these diagnostic tests show us that they aren't satisfied, then ordinary least squares is no longer blue. And in this particular circumstance, we need to define a whole sort of new set of estimators, which may not be blue, but they may be some sort of, may possess some other sort of good property which an estimator might have, in particular consistency, and under a sort of set of less restrictive assumptions, they may happen to be blue or consistent. So some of the estimators we're going to discuss here are the sort of instrumental variables estimation, GLS estimators, and sort of maximum likelihood estimators. We may also talk a little bit about GMM, but we're going to keep that to a minimum. I should also mention that I'm going to try and make this course as non-mathematical as possible. Wherever I can avoid using maths, I'm going to avoid it. And where I do use maths, there is not necessarily the need to follow those videos if you're just looking for the sort of intuition behind the theory. Okay, so the sort of second part of the course is going to be concerned with a different type of data, which we call time series data. So an example of time series data might be, let's say we have a given company's level of sales, but now we don't just have it at one point in time, we might have it across time, right? So this might represent a company's sales across time. Alternatively, we might be looking at the sort of GDP within the UK. We might be looking at sort of inflation within the UK. And time series is much more the realm of macroeconometrics opposed to microeconometrics, which is where cross-sectional data is mainly concerned. In the sort of time series section, we're going to discuss sort of properties of time series. So we're going to talk about what it means for a time series to be what we call stationary. We're also going to discuss two particular examples of time series, which we call autoregressive of order one. And we're also going to discuss sort of MA of order one. That means moving average of order one process. Again, don't worry if you don't know what these mean. We're going to discuss them in due course. So that's going to sort of compose the second part of the undergraduate course. The sort of final part is going to be what we call sort of panel data methods. So that's going to be concerned with what happens if we don't just have an individual sort of level of data at a given point in time, but let's say we have the same sort of individual's data, but across time. So we might have that individual's level of wage in 2010, and then we have that individual's level of wage in 2011. And it just so happens that for panel data, as well as sort of for time series data, we need to modify the Gauss-Markov assumption slightly to take into account the fact that our data is now sort of correlated across time. It's no longer independent. And actually, when we amend these sort of Gauss-Markov conditions, we're actually not really going to be talking about a population of data anymore. We're actually going to be talking about what we call a data generating process, because the idea is that you can't really think about a sample of data as taken from an infinite amount of time. You have to think about some sort of data generating process, which is generating samples at different points in time. So it doesn't really make sense to talk about populations when we're discussing time series and panel data. For panel data, we're going to discuss what we call the sort of between estimator. We're also going to discuss the within estimator. And then if we have sort of time, we're going to discuss fixed effects and random effects as well.